Hey there, friends, it's Kodiak here, and welcome back to Legacy Gaming and another Death Store boss guide video. Today, we're taking on the third major boss in the game, Betty. This is probably the first really challenging fight in the game that feels more like an MMO raid boss than anything else. You'll be dodging attacks left and right, and it will really test your ability to move and think quickly. As always, if you have any questions about the fight or just the game in general, let us know in the comments section below, and remember to hit that thumbs up and subscribe for more great video game content in your feeds. Alright friends, here we are taking on the third major boss in the game. Of course, this is Betty. She is a beast and an absolute challenge when it comes to the boss fights in this game. Now, her first major ability is just a jump. She'll jump around the room and she will slam on the ground, combining that with some swipes. But it's this next ability, the roll, that you'll really have to look out for. She will roll multiple times in a sequence and she will absolutely devastate you with this ability. The key here is to really just dodge roll at the end of the roll. Right before it's going to hit you, that's when you want to dodge roll. It's very easy to mistime this, so basically you're just gonna have to practice. You're gonna have to see this fight a number of times. I will admit this is one of the fights in the game that actually gave me a problem because that roll is so well tuned and it happens multiple times in sequence, so you have to be ready for it. Because she rolls and then she jumps, you're trying to figure out when to do damage, when to take on the boss, but also avoid all of the abilities. It's a bit of a challenge. And as you can see there, I just got caught by one of her rolls, and it's really easy to kind of come off the rails when that happens. Now, I am using the bomb ability this time around. I just want to see how much damage I can do on a boss with the bomb. It's a great tool for this fight, but it is slow. You can get a lot more mileage out of the bow or the fireball ability, so the bomb may not be the best tool. I just wanted to see if I could push myself and do it. Now, of course, she will keep rolling, she will keep jumping around the room. Eventually, you will push her into one of her other new abilities, which is coming here shortly. Of course, I'm talking about the snowball throw. She is an abominable snowman, after all. She shoots out a snowball in a straight line. Just add this to the list of moves that Betty brings to the table. You've got the jump, you've got the swipe, you've got the slam. Now you've got a snowball you have to deal with. And the real challenge here is, when do you do DPS on the boss? You have to get into melee range to be able to build up your range charges, but if you do that, you're gonna get hit, just like I did. So you have to be very careful. Do not be impatient. Do not try and be greedy in this fight. This is, more so than any other fight, the one that's going to punish you for being greedy. Take the hits when you can get it. Use your abilities when you can. Try not to miss like I did just there, and just do the best that you absolutely can. Now, this sequence continues. Just like the other boss fights in the game, everything here is about timing and pacing. They add one move at a time, and I really appreciate that about the boss fights in this game. I think they're all very well paced. Nothing feels overly fast or overly slow, and it really gives you time to learn the boss fights while still being challenging. Now, here is another move. She'll slam the ground and a few snowballs will fall from the ceiling. This just adds a layer of unpredictability to the fight. As you'll see, snowballs will fall throughout the rest of the encounter, and we're talking a lot of snowballs here. So as she's rolling across the room, you now have to worry about something else coming from a different direction, and that change of direction is really the challenge here. Now, my tip is to just stay as far away from Betty as you can. Of course, you're gonna have to go into melee to build up your range charges. That's just the way it is, but don't get greedy. Get two hits and then back out. Get two more hits and then back out. This fight can be brutal towards the end. You're running on gas. You've got so many things on your screen. You just have to be patient. The good news is, if you've gotten to this point, you've seen pretty much everything in the fight. There's not a lot more complexity than this. And as you can see, I have almost defeated Betty here. Just a few more hits and we will be able to get her down. Now, as always, guys, if you have any questions about this boss fight or any boss fight in Death Store, please do let us know by using the comment section below. We're always happy to help players that are struggling on boss fights, that are just looking for an edge when it comes to these encounters. So leave us a comment below and we will be happy to help. As always, friends, if you want more Death Store content in your feed, hit that thumbs up and subscribe. And remember, my name is Kodiak, and from everyone here at Legacy Gaming, thanks for watching and play on.